Hey, what's going on, everybody out there in YouTube land? As always, I am the one, the only, Revolution Hell Cowboy, and I'm back with a figure pickup video. First one in about a month or so, or whenever the last time was I did a video. I've mostly been doing separate videos because, you know, separate between wrestling, Hot Wheels, TMNT, and whatever else I buy. Plus, I've been focused more on trading card videos as, I get a lot more views for, every trading card box opening I've done. Not for all of them. I did a WWE box opening. If you haven't seen it, go watch it. WWE Champions opening. And, of course, my previous WWE 2012 openings. And, been getting trade requests, too. But I'll try to do trades occasionally. And just for trading cards. I don't trade figures. I'm sorry. No offense. Unless I know you real well and I'm willing to go down and hunt something down for you in retail. Whatever I have in my collection, it's not for trade. I mean, I have very few figures I'll consider trading off, but that's it. I mean, I love collecting figures, and that's why I'm not always doing trades, but for trading cards, I mean, sure, and I'll be willing to help people out. So anyways, got some purchases for you guys. Stuff from eBay, Amazon, Ringside Collectibles, and a few things I picked up at Walmart. Nothing from the flea market. I did go today, but I was a little low on cash, and I'm just going to get the flea market a break until the beginning of the new year. Just because the last time I was there, while the guy had some decent comics, I mean, had plenty, he wants a lot for his wrestling figures. And as for the vintage TMNT stuff, which he always gives me good deals, the last time I was there, he didn't really have the best selection. I mean, it was a good selection, but between me and all the other collectors buying them up with, you know, the new TMNT cartoon being on, I guess I can find whatever I can find, you know, and, so, I'm pretty sure he's holding out on me, too. He probably bought more, and he's waiting to make room to store the other TMNT figures he just got. So, like I said, you know, that'll probably be the beginning of the year before I pick up any more TMNT figures and more comics, but for now, with Christmas coming up, and I gotta buy gifts for the family, this possibly might be the last figure pickup video for the year. Now, it doesn't mean maybe I might not pick some figures up maybe after I'm done Christmas shopping. Who knows? I might go out Christmas Eve and see if I can find some good figures like I did last year. So stay tuned. But I'll probably be giving the online purchases a break until the beginning of the new year. So first, get into some of my recent stuff I bought. When I went to Walmart Saturday night, I actually was going to consider doing a toy run video, but with a lot of people going out Christmas shopping, I didn't want to bother. Place was packed. Barely could get my stuff checked out because, you know, of all the big lines and very few registers open. It was around 11 to almost midnight and, insane. I mean, a lot of people are getting their Christmas shopping done now, which, if you know, which is good, better now than never. And, you know, especially when people are going to start doing it last minute. I'm glad I didn't go Black Friday. I know a lot of people around here on YouTube are talking about all their Black Friday pickups. Not me. No, thank you. I can't do that. No. No! To quote Daniel Bryan. Okay, so first, let's get into the stuff I bought. My only Hot Wheels purchases. I only bought two because Hot Wheels being as cheap as they are, the standard blue blister cards being at 97 cents, it's too irresistible. I almost wanted to pick them all up. Especially anything that's a Ford, and if I can find any Mustangs, which I didn't find any Mustangs, except for like this one here, a Shelby. Cool, 67 Shelby GT500 with red line tires. Pretty badass, I like it. Please excuse the light, guys, it is bright outside. Like that paint scheme, that's pretty badass. And then this one, I hadn't seen a lot of the ones of these Hot Wheels with the new cards. The, you know, with this up here, and it's not the new for 2013 ones yet, so I haven't seen any of those, or if I have, I missed them. This is a 73 Ford Falcon XB, which I have another one that's in red, but this one's pretty cool. I like it. It's pretty awesome. They had more of these in a dump bin, which were by the front counter, and it wasn't just Hot Wheels, it was other toys too, and it was kind of an oddly shaped one. If you've been to Walmart and know what I'm talking about, then yeah, take advantage of those, you know. You might find some good ones. I've seen some ones I thought about picking up, but, you know, with all the other stuff I had to buy, I earned it for myself, you know, buy groceries too, and I also had to buy some gifts for my nephew, which I'll show those in a later video. excuse me, got the hiccups. you know, I might be doing a video here after this one, later tonight, because my nephew's coming over, so. Alright, I'm going to move on now. I'm getting into some of my recent wrestling figure purchases. So, here's some of the stuff I bought off eBay. I didn't get any Walmart, by the way. Walmart selection's crap, and I'll explain here in a little bit. Anyways, first one I got off eBay, a very recent figure of The Undertaker. This is the Toys R Us exclusive WrestleMania 28, 20-0 Undertaker. That pretty cool head scan with his mohawk. And he included the steel chair and a sledgehammer, but wait, the sledgehammer is missing. I'm gonna get mad at that seller for getting the sledgehammer. No, I'm kidding, guys. Only one man deserves a sledgehammer. The Game, Triple H. Yep, the sledgehammer from the Taker figure is in my Triple H's hand. This is the Defiant Moments Triple H. I hadn't always had a chance to find it in retail. Because otherwise, if I would have seen it, I would have picked it up. Pretty cool figure, I like it. I like it has that one-of-a-kind head scan that none of the other basic or elites have. Definitely pretty badass, I like it. Perfect to go with my Taker. So there you go. And then the last figure I picked up from eBay. And these are the only loose ones I bought. My Men on Card ones were from Amazon. Right here. The Macho Man Randy Savage. Ooh yeah. This cool figure from the All-Stars 2-pack with John Morrison. Which I don't have the John Morrison. And I just bought the Macho Man by himself. Which is alright. I like Macho Man. You know, being that I'm a big Macho Man fan. Pretty cool figure. Came with both bandanas, which I have the other bandana on my Battle Pack Macho Man, which, if y'all remember, the All-Stars Macho Man came with two bandanas, while the Battle Pack one that came out later came with no bandana, but it's the same head, so you can put the bandana on it. I don't know if that Mattel did that on purpose, or, I mean, who knows. But still, really cool figure. I like it. It's an awesome figure. Go with my other cool loose figures I have in my collection. So, yeah, there's so far all my eBay stuff. Move these guys off the side. Then next, let's get into my purchases from Amazon. This figure was hard to find when it first came out, and it was expensive. But I now got it. Elite 16 Flashback Kevin Nash with the NWO spray-painted World Heavyweight Championship, or the WCW Championship. Awesome figure. Like I said, when this figure first came out, it was, like, expensive. Ringside still has it for $79.99 on their website. And sellers were only upwards of $100. Hell, one guy wanted this for $300, and it was out of the package and missing the championship. I mean, without the championship, I mean, come on, that's pretty much the best thing about the figure. I mean, it's a cool figure, don't get me wrong, I like it. I'm glad there was Kevin Nash and his alter ego Diesel, which I already have Diesel back there somewhere. So I pretty much got everybody from Elite 16 except for Randy Orton, The Rock, and Heath Slayer, which I think I will get The Rock pretty soon. I've seen The Rock many times in retail. If I ever do go to Walmart and see The Rock, I will get him. Haven't seen Heath Slayer. Don't know if I'll get him. If I get him, I'll also try to find that Justin Gabriel with the core shirt from Elite 12. I mean, might as well. Really, if there's anything I'm looking for right now, it's Elite 18 Barrett. I mean, that figure is awesome. That and the American Badass Taker and the Jerry King Lawler. I mean, those are the figures I want from Elite 18. Now, sticking with the Elites, and I had to get this figure. Oh yeah, by the way, that Kevin Nash, I forgot to do the joke. It's just too sweet! But anyways, this figure, all I have to say is, give me a hell yeah! And that's the bottom line, cause Stone Cold said so! This figure is just too badass. Ringside Collectibles exclusive, Elite Flashback, Stone Cold Steve Austin, with both the Smoking Skull and Attitude Era WWE, or what I say, I prefer to say WF, you know, championship belts. I mean, that is just awesome. I love this figure. He's got that new head scan. I apologize for the glare, guys. I probably should turn the brightness on my iPod and then the top of the sunlight, but still. Pretty awesome figure, and I love the packaging on them. That's what I love about these new Ringside Collectible Exclusives. I also have the Macho Man back there, if you haven't seen it in one of my previous videos. Still want to get my hands on the Bret Hart. Who else they made Elite Flashbacks of? I know the other ones were ones they did in the earlier sets, like CM Punk, Kane, and the Legends Macho Man. But still, this is awesome. Had to have this in my collection. And, technically, I had to buy this through Amazon. I tried to go directly to Ringside Collectibles to buy it. And this was a couple weeks back. So it had to be after Sandy. They were still maybe having some problems. I don't know if anyone else had problems after Sandy. Trying to get an order processed through their credit or debit card. So I just bought it through their store on Amazon.com. Because I don't know. I thought maybe I was entering stuff wrong. And eventually just got to the point they'd put up an error message telling me to call a number. I'm like, man, screw that. So definitely an awesome figure, especially since people on eBay want like twice what it's going for on Ringside. Ringside just wants $39.95 for it. And that's what I paid pretty much. I paid like a total of $40 on Amazon. Ringside, I was going to pay a little more than that. I mean, I can't remember the exact price, but really cool. Now, I did buy figures at a Walmart, and like I said, if it weren't for all the people that were there, I would have done a toy run video. There was an Elite 16 Cena. I passed on it because I've seen Elite 16 at other Walmarts. This was a Walmart I don't go to anyway, but I thought I'd go to a different one anyway. Only Elite they had in stock, though. That sucks, so I'll get it later on eBay or something. They had plenty of basics, though. They had both Basic 23 and Best of 2012, which they had everybody that I had pretty much bought. Like, they had Kane, I already have, and Unico, you know, and then I also have Dan Ryan. And then they had almost everybody else, but two people I really needed. They didn't have Great Khali Lee and Sin Cara for Best of 2012, which, if they would have had those, I would have picked them up. I don't have either. And then they also had Brodus Clay. I would have picked them up, but I'm just not a big Brodus Clay fan now. Do I want a Brodus? Yeah, maybe. I'll probably get the Elite 18 one. And then they had Del Rio and Mysterio. I mean, I've already got Del Rio and another set. And then as for the Best of 2012s, they had a... the Basic 23, excuse me. I guess I'm kind of going here. I mean, okay, so that was all who they did have, I guess. They also had Triple H, which I was going to pick up Triple H, but I was like, you know what, maybe later. I mean, it was a cool figure. I'm pretty sure knowing how Triple H always seems to not really sell very well to kids because there's always so many in stock. Him and Cena, Mysterio, Sheamus, and Del Rio, and Orton seem to always be the peg warmers. But as for the other figures they had stock, they also had, I think that was actually about it. They had, of course, two Mysterios, both the 2012 and the Basic 23, which I'm sorry. I got a pass Mysterio. Until they make a cool Mysterio figure, like an Elite Flashback, I got a pass. Oh yeah, no Santino or Alicia Fox. I would have picked them up if I saw them, but Divas are hard to find, and Santino I'm not too crazy about, but I would at least like to have one Santino figure. Okay. So now, if you know me by now, my favorite line of all time is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Of course, I got to show this cool shirt off. If you probably already seen it by now, but this is an awesome shirt right here. I'm going to stand up a little. Just give you kind of a cool few, full view of the shirt. Got this kind of little paint-driven thing going on. I actually picked this up a few weeks ago. But, of course, now it's time to show you the figures. And, like I said, no flea market pickups just because I'm going to flea market a break. But I did get the new TMNT figures. And these, man, these are just too awesome. And there was only one of each in stock. Now, the Walmart I went to hardly had much TMNT left. Hardly. The basic four turtles were gone, except for a talking Michelangelo. And they had two of that in stock, which I actually got one for my nephew. But as for everybody else, Shredder, April, and the four turtles, they were gone. There was a crap load of the Krangs. I think I saw a Splinter. There might have been a Foot Soldier. But if they didn't have these three, I would have been mad. Metalhead, Fishface, oops, and Dog Pound. Now, these are awesome figures. I had to have these in my collection. And like I said, only one of each. Now, I've seen Fishface and Dog Pound at another Walmart, but Metalhead I didn't. And I do have the vintage version of this figure from the old 80s toy line. But this is awesome. And everybody seems to point this out. I mean, a bunch of people who either pick this figure up or review it. That poor Michelangelo is missing from the card. Instead, above Michelangelo is just another Raphael. Apparently, yeah, that is a mistake on everybody's figure. That anyone who got Metalhead, you are gonna see that mistake. I mean, I don't know what the heck happened at their factory when they printed out these cards to accidentally put Raphael twice instead of a Michelangelo. They didn't do it on the Fishface and Dog Pound ones, but oh well, it's a mistake. Whatever, mistakes happen. But still, this is a pretty cool figure. I like Metalhead a lot. And then we got Fishface, who's alright. I mean, I had to get him. He's an alright dude. For what I know, Zever, the kind of Dominican-looking dude. I like the figure better than the back, the more they show accurate picture of him here. I mean, because the figures are more comic book looking. They look much different than their cartoon counterparts. But Fishface is pretty cool. But this one I really like. I like this guy. And this is a heavy figure. I feel like I need to just... I think this one makes a little more noise when you drop it. But that is a bulky figure. I mean, and I like the fact that, you know, the guy he was before, Chris Bradford, who looked like Chuck Norris, now he turns into a big old dog. I'm glad he mutated into a dog, because if he would mutate into this, that would have sucked. I'm sorry. No offense, Fishface is alright, but I like Dogman. He looks awesome. Now, I mean, a lot of people are hoping that Bebop and Rocksteady return. And I'm kind of doubtful if they do. And don't get me wrong, I would love to have Bebop and Rocksteady. But these guys are like the new version. You know, like Taka Razor in the movies. And then, you know, had like Han in the 2003 version of the cartoon. Now, if Bebop and Rocksteady do return, I could see them probably just being humans this time. But we got these two cool guys. And then along with Metalhead. The only figure I still don't have from the line is Krang. And still, I'm not the biggest fan of the Krang, but I might get Krang to finish the set, because every time I'm at Walmart, my friend asked me, why don't you get it? You gotta complete the set. I'm like, yeah, I guess I do. So if you love the Krang, I'm not hating on Krang. Krang's one of those characters that I'm just warming up to. Kind of weird in the show how they go, the turtles are the ones that are trying to get us, or Krang, that is the one. Or the way they talk, it's like that Mojo Jojo talk, you know, from the Powerpuff Girls. But still, definitely happy. And I can't wait for the new figures to come out next year. Baxter Stockman, Snakeweed, and then some of the variants of the turtles themselves. So yeah, that's about it, guys. But I got one more thing. It's not a figure, but this is for anyone who likes to watch my trading card videos. The all-new WWE Heritage Pitcher cards. Did I say pitcher? Picture? Bleh, whatever. Anyways, found these last night. They had plenty of these in stock, along with some jumbo packs. Sadly, no more WWE 2012. I wanted to get those. One more box. I don't know if all the Walmarts are done selling them, or if they're just trying to make room for these. But you know what? I'm happy to have these. Don't have any cards in the set. I haven't opened this box yet. I have removed the plastic, but I haven't taken out the relic or the packs. But I'm definitely going to get ready to open these pretty soon. Might be after this video. Might be sometime later in the week. So if you're somebody who watches me just for trading cards, you know, or if you just watch me for figures and trade cards, I want you to stay tuned, because I might get an awesome relic, might get some cool cards. I can't wait to open these. So as always, guys and gals, I want to thank you very much for watching. I just knocked over the Macho Man. Would you knock me over? What'd I do to you? Okay, anyways, that wasn't bland, but it happens. But anyways, I want to thank y'all for watching. As always, you like what you saw, hit that like button, leave a comment, let me know if you ever found any of these in retail. And of course, like I say, if I mentioned this before, I don't know if I did, because I've been talking for a long time, I don't really do trades for figures, but for cards, I do. I mean, so if you're willing to see what cards I'm going to get in this box, stay tuned for that video. It'll be up pretty soon. And as always, if you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button, because I appreciate all my subscribers. I've been, you know, getting more subscribers as of late, and I don't care how many I have. I mean, you all are awesome people. I mean, I wouldn't do these videos, man, if I had no subscribers. I mean, I love sharing my collection with all y'all. I mean, and this is a community we should always share with everybody. And maybe help each other out. I mean, if I find stuff in retail, and I know you real well, and you're willing to make a good deal with me or something, then, hey, you know, I'll help you out. Or, who knows? I mean, there's some people out there that are really deserving that I know pretty well. You know? So, anyways, that's all, and of course you can like my page on Facebook, go check me out at facebook.com/RevHowCowboy, and follow me on Twitter at RevHowCowboy to hear what I tweet about when it comes to wrestling or toys or whatever randomness in my mind. And then if you want to stay tuned to anything that happens with my YouTube account, any videos I like, or if I upload a video, go to RHC ToyTube, at RHC ToyTube. I tweet there automatically just because it's how it's programmed with YouTube. So ear one, at RevHowCowboy, I might post YouTube updates there too. But, and of course, you know, That's about it. Nothing else to say. I talked for 20 minutes now. So, like I always say, rock on and keep collecting.